Hello and welcome to CollectaThought, the show where I collect my thoughts on a video game. And today we'll be reviewing Growing Up, a life sim where you play from the age of a baby until your end of high school. More on that, why that is, in a bit, and why I think it kind of brings down this game quite a lot. But regardless, this was a game I randomly found on Steam, which is kind of rare. I don't really do that a lot nowadays. And it looked very interesting. I mean, there aren't a lot of actual life sims like this, besides, you know, the famous Sims, I guess. Games where you can make a baby and have it grow to be an old man are surprisingly rare, especially in a more mundane and realistic scenario. And to be fair, I don't think that's what growing up is. And I think that's partly why I was a bit disappointed with the game, because it does sell itself as being that. For reference, here's how the game describes itself on Steam. This is the story of your life. Experience the entire journey from toddler to adulthood, which technically is true. I guess adulthood starts after you finish high school. But also for reference, after high school in this game, you really just get a cutscene and a flash forward, and then you get a baby and restart the game if you want with that baby. I think my biggest problem with this game is that it's actually very simple and linear, and I don't think that really, you know, should be the case for a life sim. What I'm talking about here is most of the events in this game are pre-scripted, with only minor changes depending on your dialogue options during these scenes. At the end of the day, you'll have three friends your whole life, which are also your romantic interests, and they're all the opposite sex, because this game either doesn't want you to have same-sex relationships, or they're too focused on their whole gimmick that once you finish the game, you get married and have a kid who is New Game Plus. Either way, it's stupid. Basically, the problem with these events working like this is that it kind of trivializes the sim aspect of it. If most of these scenes will happen either way, then what's the point? And it's not like these events are great. The writing is very okay, it's passable. There's some nice character moments sometimes, but again, it's all linear, so it isn't very satisfactory in a way that it feels like these things are happening because of your choices, and these things are just kind of happening, and in that context, it's just kind of a mediocre story. Adding to that is how these events are often just cut in between gameplay, creating scenarios where sometimes you have what's supposed to be a very emotional scene, and then immediately after that, you just go back to your daily routine without any time passing. And what is your daily routine? Because this is what the game is actually about, and this is what the game really is. This is its true colors. It's a time and resource management game, which could easily lend itself to the life sim genre, but the way it's done here feels bland, I think. So, of course, the game ramps in difficulty as you get older, but the basic idea is you can do a set number of tasks every day, and these will raise your stats in different categories, which will define the things you're good at. And to give you a rundown, basically a day will start with a skill tree that gives you some points to acquire points to the different attributes. Like, for example, you can get some skill points for physique if you want to focus on exercise, or intelligence if you want to focus on maths, or imagination if you want to go for arts. You know, it's very linear and simple in that way. The only thing here adding a little bit of a twist or randomness is the way this skill tree works. Basically, every day you have a new skill tree and you have a number of points you can spend on it. And this is kind of a way of gamifying the randomness that you have in real life, I guess, you know. Some people are just better at some things than others, and that's kind of the way this game found to gamify that. And that's all fine, except for the fact you can definitely game this system and make yourself kind of good at everything And that's kind of the goal of the game ultimately, because the game primarily focuses on the school life. It is about getting good grades. It's not so much about following a path throughout your whole life. And even though you can do that and it will affect your ending, at the end of the day, the game will have ended at the end of high school, meaning regardless of what path you chose, it never actually changes anything meaningful in the gameplay. Now, to give you a quick rundown of after the skill tree bit, what you can do is buy skills. And skills are actually like things you can study, things you can do in your free time, which will also raise your stats. These can be bought with knowledge, which can also be acquired from the skill tree, and also from doing some of these tasks you buy. Also, these skills get cheaper the higher your stats are that relate to that particular skill. Like, for example, if you want to learn geography, then you have to have a high stat in memory. So you can probably already see the gameplay loop here. You get skills so that you can raise your stats, and you raise your stats so that you can get more skills. And that is it. That's the game. You can clap now. That is the whole game from childhood to adulthood. The only thing adding to this, of course, is the time management, because you can only do so many activities a day. And then they add action points, which allows you to do extra activities. And on top of that, you also have to manage what kind of activities you do, with the other major aspect of the gameplay, which is managing your happiness and your parents' happiness. Because the way it works is, if you do things like study or work, it will make you unhappy. But doing things that you enjoy will be seen as laziness. And basically, the idea here is that doing those things will bring your parents' happiness down, which is very weird. Obviously, this is just a gameplay mechanic. But the idea that your parents get sad or mad at you because you did something other than study is, at the bare minimum, awfully toxic. But regardless of this being a game mechanic, it is a very weird thing to gamify. Especially since it does end up being the crux of the gameplay, since you'll either be happy and have your parents mad at you, or you'll be depressed and have your parents really happy with you. Which usually you don't want either or, because having either of those below a certain threshold gives you gameplay disadvantages. Like, for example, if you get down on the happiness enough to be depressed, you cannot buy any new skills, which is a big deal. The only times you'll want to kind of push it in that way is for example, when you raise your parents' happiness to a degree where it will allow you to request something from them that will usually be locked off. And these will usually be major gameplay changes, like adding an extra time slot for your activities or raising your allowance, which does change the game a lot. I'll get into that in a second. Basically, your parents have like their little store they call requests, where you can spend pride points, which you get for being a good son, that you can then spend on this request store that is asking your parents for stuff. And these higher and more important requests are only open when you have your parents at that high level of happiness. And now is when we get into money, which throws a whole wrench in the works. And the reason for that is because when you work, you make yourself less happy, but you don't make your parents happier. Do you see what's happening here? This only really becomes a thing once you reach high school, but basically when it does happen, it throws a whole wrench in the works. Because until that point, you probably had a nice time managing between happiness and your parents in such a way that usually you could bring it to so that they're both equally on the same spot in the middle of the bar of happiness. Now, because you work, they will meet on a lower part of the bar, because you're expending happiness, but you're not getting any parents' happiness in exchange. The game's response to that is then buying food. I'm not kidding. This is the only way to raise happiness that doesn't make your parents less happy. Which, once again, Very weird way to gamify that, but whatever. And at this point, regardless of what these mean contextually, you can probably understand that now it is somewhat balanced, but that also means that the game is also very predictable in the way that for anything you do, you'll probably know what to do next, creating a very repetitive and boring gameplay loop in my opinion. For example, if you do something your parents don't like, then you'll have to do then something that they do like, and if you do something that expends happiness but doesn't raise your parents' happiness, then you'll have to buy some food. It is all very simple like that, and because the rest of the game is also simple in the way that all these skills, while they may have different names and require different stats, at the end of the day it's all the same. Whether or not you go for art or sports, the gameplay will be exactly the same, and the story for the most part will be exactly the same, besides the ending. So where is the life sim part of it? It's just a time and resource management game. And not a particularly good one at that. Also because of the way this is laid out, I gotta say that it's very hard to save for anything in this game. Like for example, you can buy certain things that will just automatically raise some stats, or you can just buy aesthetic things like clothes. But because money is a needed resource to buy happiness, oh wow, another weird point this game makes. Money buys you happiness. Anyways, because money is a resource that expends the resource and is the only way to recover that resource, it really takes away from the desire to do any kind of work in the game. And I mean having to work as in having a part-time job in the game. I think maybe this would have become more interesting after high school as a full grown-up, especially since suddenly you wouldn't have to also worry about your parents' happiness. But of course, that would take a complete restructuring of the game, and I don't think they really care to do that. Or they didn't have the funds, you know. Whatever the reason is, doesn't change the fact, is my opinion, personally. So, I'm not a big fan of the gameplay loop, so let's talk about something I do like, but it's gonna end up leading to a complaint again, and that is character designs. I really like the art in this game. It was actually one of the reasons I picked it up. I really like the character designs. I thought they looked really good, and the idea that you could also create your own character was quite interesting. Even though that only really devolves into you picking your mother and dad, and that will make you look like a kid that was born from them, which is fine. It's not a complaint, it's more of an observation. What I will complain about is how none of the action in this game has art for it. So many times when something happens, not even the characters will be on screen, and it will just be the text box on the bottom. And that's personally so lame. Just add some art to the game. You know, there's like a scene where the kids go and they try to jump a river and get wet, and when they come back, their character models aren't even wet. It's such a small detail, but it would have added so much. All I'm saying is if you had visuals to go with this story that's mostly dialogue, by the way, it's not like they're describing this like it's a book. These events would be categorized as being in the visual novel genre. So add some damn visuals, it would be so much better. It would actually make me enjoy this game more. They're pre-made events anyway. If they were like randomly generated, then I would get it because you'd have to make so many of them. But that's not the case, is it? I wanted to like this game so bad. There's like, you know, it's always on the grasp of having something there, but it just never does. The soundtrack is fine, I guess. It's pretty good. It's very clearly popular music that they used as reference, and that's fine, but a lot of it is also just stock music. Like, I've played a million visual novels that have this exact same soundtrack, you know what I mean? If you hear it, you'll know what I'm talking about. Obviously, I can't do it because I believe it is still copyrighted, but you can check the gameplay footage on my second channel, and trust me, you've listened to the soundtrack if you've played some upbeat and usually very indie visual novel. Regardless of all of that though, I am very sorry for ranting so much about this game, because it's not an awful game by any means. but it's not a great game and it doesn't really do what it's trying to sell in a good way. You don't really get to sculpt your childhood as well as your parenthood with endless choices. No, there's like a very numbered set of choices. It is very far from endless. Take control of what you learn, who you befriend, and find that special someone. Yeah, like half of that is true. You do choose what you learn, but you don't choose who you befriend. Unless you're an absolute ass to the characters in the game, then they'll actively choose not to be your friend, but otherwise they'll probably just be your friends by default, and it's very prescriptive. Just annoying. It's almost like they're selling a game and they're describing it in such a way that's like, it's not a lie, it's technically true. Which, I don't know, feels disingenuous to me. The game really does not fulfill what it's kind of trying to sell you on. It's really just a time management game. And as a time management game, it isn't great. And I'm giving Growing Up a 5 out of 10. The gameplay is still fine, and of course this is an indie game which costs $10, so I'm not gonna like sit here and be like, I can't believe they didn't make the deepest game ever, even though I do think they oversell it quite a bit on their page. Regardless, in terms of recommendations, if you're looking for the same thing I do, then probably don't open it. You know, it's weird because this is what this game sells itself as, but it doesn't really fulfill that need. You know, if it sold itself as a growing up time management thing, would anyone care? That's probably the reason, right? Which I honestly don't blame it for, but also don't fool people. Yeah, I don't know. The only way I would recommend this is if you're actively looking for a time management thingy, resource management thingy that's fairly easy and also has a realistic setting with a tiny bit of visual novel to it. Which is a very specific thing that I'm sure someone wants. So if that is you, congrats, you found your game. Regardless though, I do feel important to say, don't, like, even if you agree with me, maybe you're in the same situation, you bought this game and you were a bit disappointed, don't go dump on it or do something like that. You know, it is at the end of the day an indie game, and you know, your expectations do have to be tempered to that, especially when it retails for $12 most of the time. Regardless of any of that though, I hope that you enjoyed watching, and if so, please consider subscribing, liking, and commenting, all the things you can do for free here on YouTube. And regardless of that, I hope you're having a good day and growing up. That was very cheesy.